news. The moment rapper Kehlani Camilla Hicks fatally shoots her manager in Wynwood. The shooting happened back in October. The video shows the rapper and another man arguing next to a white car. Suddenly gets physical. Two men seen on top of Hicks pinning her down. At one point, she gets up, walks away, reaches into a bag and starts shooting multiple times. Her manager does not make it out alive. The other man appears to drive off in the white car, runs Hicks over. She's now suffering from broken ribs. Police ended up charging the rapper with murder in the second degree. She appeared in court this morning and will soon be released and placed on house arrest with a $50,000 bond. Hicks claims it was all in self-defense. The only
she got a gun, yo. Yo, chill, son.
Yo!
Yo, that's crazy. That's crazy. That's crazy.
Tenant becomes a victim while doing his job. Video obtained by Pix 11 News shows a group of men fighting on board a one train at the 238th Street station in the Bronx Saturday night. Lieutenant Gypsy Pichardo tries to break it up, but the group turns on him. At one point, you can see the lieutenant outnumbered. When it's all said and done, the lieutenant was slashed with a box cutter over and under his eye and had to be rushed to a hospital.
He did sustain some serious injuries to his face, including just about 8 stitches to his face. He'll be fine. And the 2 individuals that were arrested for that, hopefully there's strong consequences on them.
Chief Michael Kemper, NYPD's head of transit, tells Pix 11 what happened to the lieutenant is a direct connection to more police officers being engaged in the system.
So arrests are up, quality of life enforcement is up, fare evasion enforcement is up. This is stuff that our riders expect us to do and want us to do.
Police arrested 2 men in connection to the attack on the lieutenant, including Marquise Webb. Sunday, on board a 4 train, police say a 27-year-old man slashed a sleeping passenger on the neck. This after going on a violent rampage inside a Brooklyn homeless shelter, where he allegedly stabbed 2 men before entering the system at New Lots and Livonia Avenues. He's now also in custody. But these recent incidents, including a man randomly attacking women in the subway last week in Brooklyn, have some passengers thinking about their own safety, especially with the holiday season right around the corner.
Well, all at risk. The moment you get in that tunnel, it's a tunnel. The moment you get in that tunnel, and God forbid, something happens.
Personally, I have limited my hours in which I use the subway.
During the holiday season, ridership is slightly up. And Chief Kemper says you can also expect to see more officers on patrol in the system as well.
We always ask people to be aware of their surroundings. And we want to provide a safe environment for our riders. Not only safe from becoming a victim of crime, but feeling comfortable.
Crying scene for a small child watching their family get robbed and beaten at gunpoint. Police in Philadelphia say the homeowner runs a business out of his home. He was outside when all of a sudden police say a 2007 or 2008 black Acura pulled up. 4 men got out and held him at gunpoint. Police say they brought him inside, tied him up, and attacked him. The victim says they took his safe, guns, and jewelry. Anyone with information is asked to call 215-686-TIPS.
Thank you. Police say a Carrollton mother stabbed her husband, then drove herself and her three children into a retention pond today. Hello, everybody. I'm Heather Hayes.
I'm Steve Eager. It's 9 o'clock. Wei Feng Ong is in Carrollton police custody tonight. She'll soon be taken to the Denton County Jail to face four aggravated assault charges. Her husband and children all survived. Those who witnessed what was happening were heartbroken. Fox 4's David Centenary live at the Carrollton Police Department. David.
Yeah, two of the children are said to be stable, but one is in critical condition. That's according to police. They also say that the father who was stabbed is expected to survive. Now, tonight, we are learning who that mother is, but we still have no idea what led to this. A Carrollton mother, Wei Feng Ong, is in jail after allegedly stabbing her husband at their home Friday morning before driving their three kids into a pond 4 miles away in Louisville.
A lot of commotion.
Adriana Lagunas' family saw the crime scene from their apartment.
Oh, my heart sank. I have children. I have grandchildren.
The children, ages 8, 9, and 12, according to Louisville PD. The vehicle was fully submerged. The child who got out on his own was on top of the vehicle while it was underwater. That's when witnesses called 911.
What kind of toll is that going to take on the long run of how long they were under?
First responders pulled the mother and two children from the vehicle. A third child freed himself. Two of the kids were resuscitated. All three are at hospitals.
Don't know what's going through anybody's mind at that moment.
It's unclear what led to this.
My heart is hurting for those children. For those children, for the father, for the mother, too.
We do not know what was going through Wei Feng Ong's mind.
Nobody knows. Only her and God know only.
But the scene she allegedly left behind is devastating.
Some days we have good days, some days we have days. But when it comes to my children, there's no way.
Now at 10:30, homeowners are being terrorized by a growing number of dinner time burglaries. One family says the brazen burglars pepper sprayed their dog during the break-in.
Another family says they think that same group burglarized their home too. KTLA's John Finolio live in Granada Hills with more. It's a story you'll see only on 5. John.
Yeah, sure, Micah, that's right. We've certainly seen an increase in burglaries like these in recent weeks. In many cases, residents were home at the time. And tonight, a Granada Hills man says he thinks there could be a connection.
My bedroom's just right in here.
George Lozano had just gone to bed Tuesday evening when he heard a noise and grabbed his cell phone.
As soon as I got wide awake, I was kind of watching them, and I was trying to dial 911 at the same time, but I couldn't. The app would not allow me to be on 911 and watch the video at the same time.
On his home security app, he watched three men wearing hoodies jump his fence and begin prowling around his home.
I was just like, okay, I know where this is going.
The whole incident unfolding quickly just after 8 p.m. The intruders began unscrewing the motion-activated light bulbs. Lozano couldn't see them clearly. He was having difficulty dialing 911.
I went to my closet where my safe is. Opened up the safe, grabbed my gun.
You can see the suspects peering into windows. Lozano says he didn't know if they were armed, but wasn't about to let them get inside and took a position near his sliding door to the patio.
I had it here, just with my hand, not on the trigger, but just parallel to the barrel. Watched him, and then the entire time chased them.
He has at least 15 cameras surrounding his house. The intruders began trying to unplug the ones they could reach. Lozano pulled back the door and stepped outside.
As soon as they heard the noise, they took off.
He chased after them, his gun in hand, the suspects jumping the fence. It's the latest in a string of burglaries and home invasions in the San Fernando Valley and surrounding areas.
This door used to match the door on the left with all the panes, and that's double pane glass. And I'm not sure what kind of tool they used to actually break the door in.
Woodland Hills resident Tim Gaspar says his home was broken into Monday evening while he and his family were out for an early dinner. They returned to find their home ransacked. Another break-in Wednesday evening in Sherman Oaks looks disturbingly familiar. The back door smashed with shattered glass everywhere. The homeowner says it happened just before 8 o'clock. And who could forget this violent attempted robbery in LA's mid-city neighborhood earlier this month? Two hooded suspects jumped the fence of a home and rushed the homeowner who was about to unlock his front door. Little did they know, this would-be victim was armed with a concealed carry weapon and fired back, getting into a shootout with the suspects in his driveway. As for Lozano, he says the suspects took off in a white four-door crossover-looking vehicle. He says he called 911, but was surprised the police never showed up.
I dialed 911, called the operator, explained to the operator what had just happened, just told him they had just gotten away. She says, okay, put me on hold. They transferred me to the non-emergency number, which I was there for like almost 45 minutes.
He even called his local LAPD station and left a message.
They have a recording. I left the recording on the machine, explained who I was, what the situation was, and I haven't heard a call back from anybody.
Comes a week after that arson investigation was launched. We're near the intersection of Alameda and 14th. You can see work under the freeway continues tonight. And with the reopening days away, investigators are now looking for someone they believe is connected to the blaze that shut this stretch of freeway down November 11th.
It's absolutely insane. It takes us to a different route every time. I went and dropped them off at Santa Monica. When I came back to Rialto, it took us through a different route. Now it's a different route again, and the traffic is just insane.
As traffic around the 10 freeway closure downtown causes bumper to bumper, authorities are now releasing images of a person of interest who they believe may be connected to the massive blaze, spreading about 8 acres as it torched pallets, construction materials, and used vehicles under the extremely busy one-mile stretch of freeway driven by hundreds of thousands to get to and from downtown L.A. CAL FIRE officials described the man about 6 feet tall, wearing blue shorts, a black jacket, black backpack, a green scarf, and a knee brace on his right leg, adding he appeared to have suffered visible burn injuries to his left. The fire torched more than 100 columns of the freeway and forced around-the-clock repairs from Caltrans and contracted construction crews, with officials urging commuters to consider using public transit to avoid it all.
We're going like this hardcore punk techno slash synth pop show. People are starting to show up now because they're finding parking right now, you know, so it's kind of just like a terrible situation that we're in right now.
Apex Development has leased the land under the freeway since 2008, with documents showing state investigators repeatedly identified fire and safety hazards at a sublease storage space under the freeway where homeless people were camped out.
Are you looking forward to it reopening on Tuesday?
Absolutely, yes. Can't come soon enough.
CAL FIRE investigators are asking for the public's help in locating that person of interest connected to the fire. Meanwhile, Governor Bass, or I should say Governor Newsom and Mayor Bass, are planning a news conference here at 7 a.m. tomorrow.
Tonight, we're learning more about the fatal shooting at a New Hampshire psychiatric hospital. A security guard there lost his life helping stop an armed gunman from getting into the building. 12 News reporter Christian Benavides has the latest on that investigation.
The 33-year-old gunman who walked into this psychiatric hospital in Concord, New Hampshire, with an intent to kill, was armed with a 9mm pistol and additional ammunition on hand. He entered the lobby, first encountering 63-year-old security officer Bradley Haas, who was unarmed. Haas was shot and killed. Officials say he saved lives.
He will now be remembered forever as a man who died protecting patients, staff, and visitors at New Hampshire Hospital.
The suspect, identified as John Medore, was transient, according to authorities, most recently living out of a hotel. He was shot dead by a state trooper who was stationed at the hospital.
The state trooper who engaged the suspect was not hurt. Although I am not able to comment on the specifics of this investigation at this time, I am extremely proud of the trooper's actions that without a doubt prevented additional loss of life.
A video tonight of a mob taking everything not nailed down at a Nike store in South LA. Store employees say this isn't the first time this has happened and might have been the same group. KCAL News reporter Lori Perez is live outside the Nike community store in Watts, where thousands of dollars of merchandise was stolen. Lori.
Well, Pat, this store has been hit so many times, despite the fact that there is an LAPD trailer set up literally feet from the entrance. It is totally out of control here, so much so that some locals say they are willing to get involved to help stop it themselves. Tonight in this parking lot, neighbors are set up on one side of the parking lot as an LAPD car with officers are patrolling on another side. It's the latest stunning video of a flash mob theft, this time a group clearing out the Nike community store in Watts, throwing stacks of shoes and armfuls of clothing into trash bags they used to carry out the loot. LAPD says just before 6 p.m. Sunday, 17 suspects rushed into the retailer and rushed out with about 12 grand in product. They released these photos, hoping someone recognizes a face or the clothing. Investigators say it's at least the 10th time it's happened at this very store, 24 hours after the latest hit.
I just think it's sad. You know, it's sad that this is what it's come to. You.
Some paying customers are shaking their heads in frustration as others...
It's just embarrassing, man.
...say they're ready to do more than that. This group was camped out in the Nike parking lot tonight.
So now, guess what? We patrolling right here, and this is where we gonna be at. It gotta stop, and we gonna put a stop to it. We don't need no police involved. We gonna take it to the streets.
Tough talk from locals who are taking the targeting personally.
Yeah, I'm born and raised right here, you know what I'm saying? So, like, y'all take it from me.
Why is it frustrating to you?
Because we ain't the one doing it and we live here. But if they come right here while we're right here, they won't be the ones doing it either.
Right.
Guarantee that.
Just last month, L.A. County...
Where's he at?
Rifle and started shooting. I ran. So if you guys know anybody that's in Walmart right now, call and check on them because he shot like 10 times and I don't even know how much more afterwards. But I just know I'm so lucky to be alive.